The help you need to grow in your data analyst career might just be a data analyst mentor. I've mentored hundreds of people looking to make a career change to data analyst, to get that next promotion in their career, and looking to leverage analytics more effectively. This has spanned the range from people that worked in accounting, audit, supply chain, even things like the oil and gas industry where they're looking to upskill for that next role. And these are people that have gone into roles like business analysts, financial analysts, data scientists, marketing analysts, and the list goes on. I'm Jen. I help demystify analytics and analytics careers. I've worked in the analytics space for over 15 years now in roles ranging from data analyst, business analyst, data governance, to managing these teams. I've also built my own analytics consulting business and analytics training business. During that time, I've mentored hundreds of people, and I've also had plenty of mentors of my own. Those have ranged wildly depending on the point in my career that I was at and what I specifically wanted to work on with that mentor. Some were really topic specific, some were more company specific, and others were more about helping me figure out where I wanted to go in my career. Let's break down a few different elements of data analyst mentorship. While I'm going to talk specifically about data analysts and mentoring them in this video, this can apply a little more broadly. I work with people across the analytics spectrum, so it's not specific just to data analysts. Why do you need a data analyst mentor? There are a lot of different reasons that someone might choose to work with a mentor specifically within the analytics space. And there are times when you don't need a mentor. No one requires you to have a mentor at any point in your career if you don't want one. But chances are high that you're at least intrigued at the idea because you're here watching this video. Here are a few of the most common reasons that people come and work with me as their data analyst mentor. One very common reason that someone might want a data analyst mentor is they're looking to change jobs. This could look like making a complete career change into their first data analyst role, or it could look like taking that next step, getting a promotion, whether that's moving down a more technical path, changing companies, or working towards a managerial path within the analytics space. All of these are good reasons why you might want to work with a data analyst coach or mentor. Some people have very specific ideas of what they want their next step to be, and that's great. Others might still be trying to figure it out. And that's great too. That's one of the things that I work with as a data analyst mentor, is helping you figure out what the right next step is for you if you haven't quite figured it out. You might also work with a mentor to help you prep for interviews. You need a little practice, you want that outside insight on how your interview skills are, where you can tidy up, and want to make sure that you're really set up to perform well when you go into that data analyst interview you have scheduled. You might want a mentor because they can give you some outside support. They're able to look at things outside of being in the middle of them and give you help on what it looks like to move forward, whether that's the really big picture or sometimes it's on day-to-day things that you're encountering in your job. Those reasons why you might work with a mentor obviously are going to overlap with how a mentor can help. I mentioned that you could get some outside support. Having that high-level view that's not in your day-to-day can be really helpful to help you get through roadblocks, to be a sounding board that help you move forward with whatever you're working on. Mentors can help you focus your energy and your investment. Whether that's a time investment or a financial investment, it's good to focus on what skills are going to make the most difference, what the most valuable next step that you could take is, and how they fit with the time and resources that you actually have available to you. Because we don't have unlimited budgets of time or money to spend on where we want to go. Because a mentor can provide expertise in a specialty area, they can help ensure that you're really utilizing the resources you have available in the best way possible. For most people in a mentor-mentee relationship, whether that's a paid mentorship or you're working with someone at your network, they find that situation can be very motivating to help them take the next steps because they have that accountability that you might not have if it's just you working on your own. Let's talk a little bit more about paid versus free mentorships. Mentorship can take on a lot of different forms. I mentioned for me, it's looked very different throughout my career. What I needed from a mentor my first year in the workforce is very different than what I need now. My goals are also very different now than what they used to be. Some of those mentorships have been with people in the company that I'm working at the time. Those have been sometimes very formal mentor-mentee situations, and other times more casual, where it was someone that was levels above me in the organization, who I really connected with, and was willing to invest some time in helping me grow within my career. I also have had a variety of different types of mentorship relationships in terms of how specific they were. So I mentioned some of those general career growth type things, but I've also worked with mentors with very specific focus areas that help me on very specific things that I want to grow in. And they have the expertise that I don't have. So they can help me really tailor the efforts that I'm putting in and make sure that I understand what the best way to move forward is. If you have people within your network or your organization that are open to mentoring you and have the skill set to do so, that's fantastic. You should absolutely take advantage of those resources where you can. Other times you might reach out to a mentor who's more specialized in a particular area or has more of the expertise you want. Sometimes people come to me for mentorships because they don't want anyone in their organization to know that they're working towards the next step, especially if that's leaving the company or entirely changing careers. They don't have people in their network that have a lot of expertise in that area, maybe on the hiring side like I do. Every situation is different, and what mentorship looks like for you could look very different across the course of your career, or even could look like working with multiple different mentors on different topics at the same time. There's no one-size-fits-all answer. Okay, you've decided you want a mentor. How do you find a data analyst mentor now? There are a few criteria I look for in any mentor that I work with, and I'd suggest might be good criteria for you as well. The first is that they have more specialized experience in the area you want to work with them on. They are bringing more knowledge to the table so they can help you. You don't want to work with someone that doesn't have a lot of knowledge in the area that you're trying to improve on. Ideally, they also have a track record of success with helping others. Everybody starts somewhere, so different mentors or coaches are going to have more experience than others, but just because you're able to build your own career successfully doesn't mean you're able to communicate knowledge successfully. We've all had good teachers and bad teachers somewhere in our educational past, and they probably mostly knew the material they were teaching well, but some are better at communicating it than others. So look for people that can communicate that knowledge, that specialty that they have, in a way that's helpful for you. I also always want a mentor that makes me feel heard, that they take time to learn about me, about my background, my situation, and are taking that into account. If all I'm getting is very generic advice that doesn't have any tailoring to my specific situation, I could have just gone and taken a course or read a book, which are fantastic resources, but they're very different investments than working with a mentor or a coach. You may be able to find people that meet all of these criteria in your company or your network, or you may decide that you need to hire someone like me to be your mentor. If you're considering working with me as a mentor, here's a little bit what that looks like. The first step to work with me as your data analyst mentor is to fill out a short form questionnaire. I don't work with everyone that reaches out to me about mentorship. And that's for good reason. I want to make sure that if I agree to mentor you, that I know I can really help you. I want to make sure you're getting value out of investing your time and your money in working with me as a mentor. I want both of us to feel like it's a good fit. Obviously, every mentorship looks a little bit different because it is custom to each person. We'll look at a few of the most common forms those mentorships take, though, and look at what is involved in each of those. Keep in mind, while I'm talking about data analyst mentorships, this is really true of any role within analytics. I work with people that want to be business analysts, financial analysts, are looking for that next step, that promotion as a healthcare analyst, a marketing analyst, any of these analytics roles. Also, people in data science are looking to step into data science. The first common type of mentorship is a data analyst mentorship for career change. You're looking to make a career change into an analytics field. These mentorships start out with talking about your background and your experience. We also talk about what your goals are, and these could be really specific, that you want a marketing data analyst job, for instance, or they could be a little more generic, what you want your work-life balance to look like. Is Is remote important? Is location in the country important? What skills do you really like working with and which ones are you not so much a fan of? I have to understand what you really want so I can make good recommendations. We talk about questions that you might have about making that switch, any concerns you have, and go through pros and cons of some different options. And the end of that first session is a really actionable plan where you can go and take those steps to get into that role. For some people, they like to DIY everything from there. They want a one-time meeting and they're good to go. For many others, I work with them throughout the process until they actually land that job, helping them prepare their resume, helping them prepare for interviews, and even negotiating salary. The next type of mentorship is a data analyst mentorship for job support. For people that are already working in analytics, maybe they're earlier in their role or they're having some issues that they just can't work through, this is ongoing mentorship support where we talk about what's going well for you, what your challenges and roadblocks are, and help solve them. This isn't about technical solutions. You can go Google the technical solution, but maybe you're stuck on how to approach the business problem you're encountering or how to navigate the political landscape within your company. Sometimes these mentorships are also for people that aren't working in analytics yet. They're working in roles where they have data as a heavy part of their job or want it to be more of a part of their job. And so they come to me for support for mentorship to help them incorporate data and analytics better in the work that they're doing. The last main type of mentorship that I have is data analyst mentorship for promotion or job change. This almost always includes a lot of interview prep. It typically involves some resume prep, but we sometimes also will talk about what your skill sets are and if there are some skills that would be easy for you to pick up that really strengthen your overall profile. This is a lot about polishing that knowledge and skill you already have and figuring out how to convey it to that hiring manager on your resume in the interviews. So you're able to put the best version of yourself out there and really share all of that knowledge that you have. You have the skills, you have the experience, you just need to figure out how to take that step to communicate it. If you have any questions on data analyst mentorship, leave them in the comments below and I'm happy to answer them. If you're interested in working with me as your mentor, I'll drop the link to the short application I have down in the description, and that webpage that it will take you to also gives you a bit more detail on what is involved in different types of mentorship. Again, I've listed some of the more common ones, but mentorship is custom to each person. We all have unique goals. And while there's certainly similarities and overlaps in what we do and what that looks like and the steps we might need to take, I want your experience to be unique to you because you're unique and what you have to offer in the data analytics space is probably unique as well. Thank you so much for watching.